It is back to the classroom for female government officials in Kogi State, who were taken through the rudiments of security protocols, diplomatic and social etiquette as demanded by their offices and status as public officers. The colorful event, which took place at the Glass House in Lokoja from Monday 11 to Tuesday 12 December 2023, was organized by the Kogi State First Lady, Mrs. Rashida Bello. The First Lady noted that understanding protocols as well as having security awareness are important to executing the responsibilities of their various positions.
She told us to be security conscious, and that is very important. And then the police also told us to always reach out. We should reach out. We have telephone numbers. Reach. Whenever you're in a difficult position. And then the immigration also told us about different types of international passports. This lecture is actually overdue. Immediately we were able to bring on board women as deputy chairman in various local governments. And, so I've been receiving, reports from here and there. They don't longer stay at home. They don't longer respect their husbands. And it's been a serious worry because I didn't bring that idea for you to lord over your husbands. It was just a way of empowering women to bring us up to be important in our society. So, Vice Chairman, this is directly to you. Being vice chairman doesn't make your husband a slave. He is the man of the house. Yeah, our husbands, no matter how wretched, as far as he is the one that got married to you, you don't have any rights. Whatever you think you're earning, you don't have any right to speak to your husband like the houseboy. You don't even speak to anybody in bad manners. We've been taught, and I believe as women we should even know this.
The seminar witnessed sterling presentations by carefully selected resource persons from government, the Nigerian police, immigration, NAPTIP, NGOs and others.
But in this era of kidnapping, armed robbery, it is advisable that if you are traveling, you share your live location or coordinates. So if you have an Android phone, please just go to anybody that would like to send a message to and you open to your Android phone. This place here that you see something like an attachment, this small sign. Open to your WhatsApp, as you can see mine. You see this little sign here that looks like attachment. You click, you see some icons, about seven. This other one here that says location, green. When you click, do you intend to share it for 1 minute, 5 minutes, or 1 hour? So if you're on transit, traveling along the road, it's whether you share for 1 hour depending on the distance or you share for 8 hours.
For all Nigerians, even for a day old baby, and the requirement for it is your birth certificate, your NIN. For adults, birth certificate, NIN, and state of origin certificates. Then you have, if you are getting the passport for the first time, then you need a guarantor. Your guarantor must be a person that has passports before. So we need the data page of the passport and one passport photograph of the person. While your own, you attach it with two passport photographs. If you are appointed as government appointees, immediately your tenure ends. That you are not going to enjoy that privilege again, unless any other recommendation from the governor or from Mr. President.
How do I maintain good human relations? As a person, as for Rashida Arike Ayoade, how do I maintain good human relations? I have to speak to people. Number one, speak to people. Don't keep mute. Number two, smile at people. Even when you're greeting them, smile at them. Let them know your greeting is genuine. You don't greet by frowning. Good human relations says greet smiling at people. Be friendly and helpful. If you want friends, you must show yourself to be a friend. If you want to be somebody that you want people to befriend you, then how far have you shown yourself to be friendly?
Qualities or attributes of a good protocol officer or officers. First and foremost, he or she must be a neat person, that is, his dressing pattern must be neat and dignified. Two, he or she must be fluent in his or her presentations in any occasion or ceremony. Three, he or she must be calm and humane and must be civil in his or her approach to people at any occasion or problem. Four, he must not be aggressive or arrogant all the time. He or she must be presentable and be well dressed to others. He must be educated and committed to his or her duties of responsibilities.
There is a story that we were told 2011. Let me start with that, so that we'll understand on etiquette, social etiquette. 2011, when we attended it, I think he was an ambassador from Foreign Affairs Ministry, came and told us something. Every woman, every person must be very observant of your surrounding so that you represent this country well, wherever you go to. He told us that there was a state banquet at Buckingham Palace, the Queen of England, that time, organized a state banquet where dignitaries of all countries came with their wives. And our own was there. And you know, when it is banquet, the head gives a nod after serving, whether you should start or not. We were told that time that as soon as they said, the queen sat down, but she hadn't given a nod to start. She gives a nod, she gives a sign. It could be Bon Appetit, it could be Enjoy Your Meal, whatever it is. She hadn't done it. And our own sister started eating. Who has heard that story before? You've heard it before. That's good. Somebody is validating what I've heard. Our sister, I don't know who she is. Nobody told us her name. She started by eating. And other country dignitaries were so, you know, embarrassed that our sister didn't know that. Is anybody from Foreign Affairs here? No. They were so embarrassed, and our own dignity was embarrassed. I want to tell you, women, please, wherever you are, be observant. Don't be rushed. Don't rush to do anything. There is an aura. There is an aura that an average woman should carry. It's not about how you deck yourself. Just like our sister said, it starts from public relations. And you observe, you are friendly, you observe how things are done. And that day, because of that thing that woman, our sister, committed, it was decided at the Foreign Affairs Ministry that there must be protocol and etiquette training. And that was how it started.
Protocol people have a lot to do before the madam arrives. Get a copy of the program.
get the seat secured and know where she'll be sitting. We should equally understand that even in seating arrangements, for example, the highest person is at the center. The next to him or her is on the immediate right. We need to know this. The highest dignitary is at the center. Next to him or her is on the immediate right. And next to that second person is on the immediate left. And then the others will follow. This one is part of etiquette and it has protocol implications that we all should understand.
Highlights of the event were the presentation of certificates of attendance to delegates, a special brunch with the First Lady, presentation of souvenirs, and group photographs.